Thanks, Dan Wittes and Bill O'Reilly in a What the Heck Just Happened segment tonight. New poll, again from the Pew people, asking young people what they care about. In the group 18 to 29, they care about the World Cup at a rate of 24%. Supreme Court decisions, 6%. Violence in Iraq, 13%. IRS losing emails, 10%. VA scandal, 15%. So they don't really care very much about anything. You're now to analyze the young folks, two old guys, Bernard McGuirk and Greg Gutfeld, author of the book Not Cool, which is a young person's expression, Gutfeld. All right, and why don't they care about anything?
It's no surprise. Soccer is probably the greatest thing ever in the world.
Yeah.
This is a sport that is so interesting, it doesn't need scoring. Now imagine if you took all the scoring out of an NBA game, took away all those baskets, how much faster it would be. By the way, in Italian, soccer means sleep.
Right?
Did you know that? But it's not surprising. Our country is in the toilet, so we'll look at anything, even soccer, to take our minds off it. I actually took up nude Pilates. Me and Dobbs in the park.
You and Lou Dobbs?
Yeah, in the park.
What park is that?
Bryant Park, about 3 a.m. I pretend to walk a dog. It's got me off.
All right, now, we got absolutely nothing out of that answer. Do you have any reason at all that young people don't care about anything?
Of course, because we raised a bunch of common denominator nitwits. I mean, you see, you have Jesse Waters goes out and he documents the fact that you can tell a young person that the French bomb Pearl Harbor, and they believe it. I mean, they think a misogynist is somebody who can give you a back rub, or you know, they don't know Ghana from your mama. It's unbelievable.
All right, so you think it's the collapse of the educational system that just driven the apathy,
and the way we raised them. We didn't tell them
challenge
to
them
exactly
in
right.
any way.
If it's not trending on Twitter, they don't care about it. I mean, maybe if we had something like
I think it's the machines. I really do, because it is at a point, and 24%. No, the machines that these people carry that we had to take away from you right before the segment began.
Yes.
All right, those
that
machines.
Was a neck massager.
Because they you could just blot out the whole world. You could just blot it out, create your own insipid world that means nothing, and still be functioning.
But it also has enabled more conversation and communication. So you could argue the opposite, that it has gotten people more in touch with politics and pop culture.
And then when you have the poll that says they don't care anything about politics, what are you discussing? That I don't care about politics? That I'm not cool?
That's a fair point.
Okay. I don't know. I don't want to overwhelm either of you with logic. So let's go on to the next deal. This is a reaction to the Hobby Lobby Supreme Court ruling that said if you are a corporation that has strongly held religious beliefs, we're not going to force you to buy a birth control device that may be you consider to be abortion. Here's how CNN commentator Ashley Banfield reacted.
I started to think yesterday, as I was trying to sort of digest everything I was hearing at rapid pace, what if this were a Muslim family that owned a company, and they were very strict in their religion. They did not believe that women should be coming to work unless they had permission slips from their husbands. Is this the kind of thing that they now could mount a case and take this all the way to the Supreme Court? And now, heavens to Betsy, there's actually precedent for a religious issue trumping civil rights laws. Sally?
Well, this is exactly the danger in this case.
Is it really?
Heavens to Betsy, Bill. Hey, I'm glad to see. I haven't seen that lady for a while, but the one with the hot glasses, Ashley Banfield, I'm glad she landed on her feet. But the way she's talking, it sounds like she might have landed on her head. I mean, that's outrageous. She's engaging in Islamophobia in order to justify her religious bigotry.
It's a slippery slope that if you give a Christian concern this window, but you don't have to do an abortion mechanism that they consider to be one, morning after pill, that then everybody of the Muslim religion will be wearing burqas in the marketplace, and you know they'll force them to do that.
See, I'm for that. I would like to see a burqa Fridays, the opposite of casual Fridays. I don't need to see khaki shorts. I don't need to see people's knees. But you know, this is the first time I've seen mainstream media concerned about Sharia law. To be, if a conservative brought it up, they were nuts. They didn't care about Irsi Ali being banned from Brandeis for being a victim of Sharia law. By the way, she talks about Muslim businesses. She should give us a specific example of a Muslim business that might do this, because it also, the case specifically says this does not apply to other religious exemptions. So this is a completely bogus point.
Okay. So you think that it's fabricated?
Yes.
For the sake of what?
for the sake of, well, just for politics, political reasons.
Because, political.
Oh, of course it is.
Right. Because, to make the Supreme Court look like a bunch of fascists.
Oh, to make the right, the people who support the decision look like a bunch of fascists so that they can win at the ballot box.
And I hope that Ms. Banfield isn't going for the younger market because only 6% of the 18 to 29 Americans care about the Supreme Court decision.
Yeah.
Not a lot. All right, there's Gutfeld, McGurk, everyone. Dennis Miller will return in this slot next week, and he would like you to know that the Boulder Fresher Show in Rapid City, South Dakota on July 25th, 95% sold out. Fargo, North Dakota the next night, July 26th, 90% sold out. So if you want to see us in the Dakotas, you got to get on it. Also in the fall, we see everybody in Boston, Philadelphia, Las Vegas, West Virginia. BillO'Reilly.com has info on all the shows. On deck, Laura Ingraham will unveil her immigration plan on The Factor. Upcoming.